Hey guys, today's play game of Tales of Phantasia. So this was originally released for the Super Nintendo in 1994. However, it was only in Japan, didn't really get a Western release or translated English release until 2003, and this is the version that we got for the Game Boy Advance. So yeah, it is the first game in the Tales series, which is still ongoing. So it's a fairly, not, I wouldn't say like it's really popular, definitely not as popular as Dragon Quest or Final Fantasy or Persona. But it's still a fairly popular Japanese RPG series, but this was the one that started it all. So, yeah, and this is the first time, the GBA version is the first time that people in the West really got to see it. So, let's check it out. Not played this game before. Have played a lot of Tales games,
but I haven't played this one. Amidst the abounding light of heaven.
Okay, so one of the cool stuff is that it actually...
at the gate to the underworld.
This actually had a voice acting, like, yeah, full voice acting in this game was really cool.
What the heck is that? Phantasia! Indignation!
So yeah, the full voice acting was kind of special for this game, because on Super Nintendo, there's not that many games that have full voice acting. I know Tales of Phantasia was one of the few RPGs to have full voice acting in the game, like, well, I mean, voice dialogue. The only other game I know of is Star Ocean, which is another game that was never actually released in the West. At least not the original Super Nintendo version. And that game also had full voice acting as well. But yeah, Tales of Phantasia was... yeah, this was quite a, an ambitious game for the time. Full voice dialogue in the Super Nintendo era. And even for GBA, I mean, it's kind of rare to see full voice acting even for GBA. GBA is actually where we got a lot of games that were previously didn't come out in the West. Pretty cool. Thank you. Your name is just a traveler. I'm a traveler. Imagine if your the name of your I mean, just imagine if your name was the exact same as your job title. It's gonna be hard to make it to change job titles after that. This guy's just called Swordsman. That's gonna make it hard to ever change jobs, right? It's like, my name's Swordsman, my name's Weapon Shop Owner. It's gonna be hard to change jobs after that. You won't even sell me it. Okay, here we go. Yeah, sell me some weapons. Well, I don't have enough gold for any of this. Damn it. I've only got 100, they don't give me much gold to start out with. Okay. I guess it all depends. Every RPG, you get different amounts of gold. Some start you off with nothing, some start you off with 100, some start you off with like 1,000. It depends on the game. Various amount of gold that you start out with. It's not really real-time, but it's kind of like a real-time-like like battle system.
I did it.
Nice voice dialogue as well. But yeah, it's been like the pseudo-real-time active battle time system that they use. I think that's the case in Tales of Phantasia 2, which is the first game in the series. After it. Yeah, random encounter. All these older games have random encounters, so that's too surprising. At least most of the Japanese RPGs back then. There's only a few exceptions, like Chrono Trigger, Secret of Mana. Those don't have, or Terranigma, but those are action RPGs. Well, not Chrono Trigger, but Terranigma and Secret of Mana are action RPGs. Chrono Trigger, yeah, that's just a unique game in itself. But it does, yeah, I like the games that doesn't have the random encounters. It's kind of a way, it's kind of too grindy. It forces you to grind, basically, which I don't like. Giant bees. Pseudo active real time battle system. It's a little bit weird.
I did it,
Gald. They don't call it gold, they call it Gald. You might as well just call it gold at that point. Why even bother calling it Gald? What the heck happened to the tree? Yeah, the combat system is kind of unique. I mean, it's almost like a platform game, a side scroller. It's almost like you're playing a side scroller game. Gald. Got it, guys, not gold. Gald. We're being attacked by monsters. Turn back. I did it.
I never met.
Huh? What did he say? He said something different. Oh no. What the heck? They're all dead. Oh my god. What happened here? Damn. No, they slaughtered my family. Those bastards. slaughtered everyone in the village. Oh my god. One battle, I'm ready. Bug bears. So are they a bug or are they a bear? They can't make up their minds, huh? Bug bear. At least a giant bee, I know what that is, but... Bugbear doesn't even know what it wants to be, a bear or a bug. So indecisive, right? Well, that's probably an answer there. Not enough gal. Damn it. That's all the apple gel I can get right now. Man, I can't escape from these battles. Oh my god, stupid birds again. The owls.
I did it! I did it!
No, that's only for the ground. I see. Only for ground.
I did it!
like these flying little guys too. I have enough money left for armor, unfortunately. Man, just kill me all those owls and bees. Takes up a toll on you. Bush baby. Damn it, I don't have money for apple pill. What the heck? My uncle's betraying me. What? My uncle betrayed me. He sold me out to these guys. Damn it. Oh no. Alright guys, I'm stopped here, but this is Tales of Phantasia, and yeah, this is the first entry in the Tales series, and this, on the GBA, it's the first time the people in the West got it as an official release, and yeah, it's pretty solid JRPG. I wouldn't say that it's up there with Final Fantasy VI or Super Mario RPG or Earthbound, not that level, but still, it's a pretty solid JRPG, I think, especially, you know, for the Super Nintendo, so, you know, a lot of great 2D RPGs of that era. So that's it, guys. Tales of Phantasia. Thanks for watching.